Hey, how you doing? And welcome back to another Brigandine Let's Play. This one's going to be a little bit sooner than you probably would expect. I wanted to get at least two videos out this week because I have other multiplayer stuff and other things, other videos I do also. But as you can see, the map right here, the one is totally destroyed. If you missed that, probably not. You probably saw that. That was pretty easy. That was pretty interesting. I'm a little worried. I think Drist could totally get destroyed here, because the Empire's taken so much territory. Well, my ally's kind of doing okay. He's kind of going back and forth. You know, he could possibly lose with the Empire getting stronger like this, maybe. But Drist, from what I looked, he's going to attack here, definitely. He's got the army to attack it. He could attack here too, possibly. I don't know. But what I'm doing is I'm sending my Dinadan team down to Hadrian to defend. And possibly attack here too. If Drist does nothing, I'll have him attack just to get some experience. Just to put the Empire on defense for a little while. So we'll do it like that. And then I'm going to have Cai attack here also. So I'm going to try to fit in as many battles as I can. As fast as I can. I know I didn't do too much with some other stuff. Which probably, I guess I have to show you this. I did class up. Off-screen, I just classed up Scuba Steve, so he's Poseidon now. I also got Bramble up to a Maneater, and, Percival? I think he got up? Wait, which one got up? Oh, there was another level up. Oh, the Pegasus. I think it was a Pegasus, yeah. So, pretty much, let's see if there's any equipment. Well, I got the Ice Javelin, but I don't have a Lancer class, so... Alright, so we have to quest. I thought I went to quest. Oh, he's here. Oh, jeez. I thought he was over there. So we're gonna quest Shutleis right now. Gonna get as many people questing as possible. So we'll do it like that. I'm going to attack up right now. And then I'm gonna attack up right away again once I get the chance. So that's pretty much it. They should be down here. Let's see what the Empire put here, because this is going to be somewhat... Okay, Drist will come in here. That's definite. That's a guarantee. Drist probably will come there too. I mean, I don't know what he's got here. If he stops moving everything around like crazy, then he could, but he can't attack this. Not with these two leaders. That won't work. He could have had something going for him, but he keeps moving everybody around. Look at that. Drist is still moving around. Yeah, that's... no. I mean, they could attack there with that tiny force. We'll see what happens, I guess. I can't say myself, but let's see. New Almechia is invading Ultrut. Yes! Good. Okay, they're kind of pushing out. Not that way, though. I don't really want them attacking that way, but... What can I do? What can I do? Not much. Not much I can do with that, you know? Good thing is, though, I can move through my ally if I have to. If I get kind of backed up somewhere, I can move through my ally. So, I welcome you. I will welcome you in the Norgard way. Anyways, I don't see him staying. I don't want to auto this because I don't want to somehow pull a Cai, you know, and be all by myself. Have Cai be all by himself and just get shot down dead. Let's see here. Yeah, everything else is pretty good right now. We'll go with that. I don't mind if the high centers in the front lines. They're not gonna get too far. Nah. I'm not gonna get that far. I don't think Cai's gonna get all the way up there. The way the land is positioned doesn't seem to really work very well with trying to move in this area. I was just kind of wondering what'll happen with that. Oh, he's staying. Okay, so he's staying. Well, if he's gonna stay, I didn't really want to move around like this, but I guess I don't have a choice now, do I? I wanted to stay on all one side, but we can work it like this. This'll work out fine. This'll be okay. So, the whole plan is, as you've been wondering, there are two other characters besides, because what's going to the final fight with Bulnoil is Cai and Dinadan, because Dinadan was picked, and I picked Cai. But you guys and gals picked Dinadan, and there are two other options that have two votes for it, which one more will conclude the vote. One is for Merriot, and the other one is for Shast. So, one more vote for either of those will push them into the final fight with Bulnoil. So that's the game. That's a game plan. We're pushing for that. Let's see if it's right there. I don't know if that's the best spot, but... can I get you up in the front lines? I don't even know if I can. Yikes. Guess I'm gonna have to put the Centaur in the front for now. I don't really need to, but... I don't know. If there's some way they could get in there, I guess they really can't. But I would move the Pegasus out of the way. I'm surprised they just stayed. I was already... I think I'm two spaces away already? Wait. One. Two. Let me see what the squares look like. Maybe that is three. But the ghoul's close enough. He'll come out and engage me. Hydra's gonna be a little bit hard on me right at the moment. But I probably could kill it. I'll try a little battle tactic here to see if this works. Oh yeah, he can't go in the water right now. Well, he can in a minute. In a minute. Let's go there. Gotta save the scorpion still. So Shast, I turned him into a barbarian that probably are wondering, why did you turn him into a barbarian? Well, I just wanted to see if there was some other skills I could give him. I never really turned Shast into barbarian before. I don't know if that's going to mess things up, but I never tried it. I wanted to try it. Well, this is the only water thing I can get here to kind of plug this lineup. Let's just go there. I might throw Shast in the front lines just to get some experience. Yeah, that would be a good idea. Okay, D or Alucard? Who's going out the front lines? Well, we gotta level them up evenly, probably. I'd like to get Shast out there, though, because I want him to get some experience, but I don't know how much I'm gonna get from him. You know what? Let's just have these guys cover the flank a little bit. It probably won't get attacked much anyways, but let's just do it like that. And I still can't hit him here. So I don't need to worry about leveling up Cai too much. He's at 28, he'll be just fine. You know, this would be a good time to level up my Pixie, actually. Let's do that. Yeah, that's a good time to level it up. Not much here. I think Vinard could attack, but he could leave too. Hard to specifically say. I don't want to kill this thing off in case he decides to stay, because he still has some stuff here that could work for him. I'll try it like that, but Vinard doesn't have... He might have more monsters than me, possibly, but just the quality. He just doesn't have the quality now. I mean, the Tiamat, the dragon, the demon, or not the Tiamat, sorry, the Hydra, the dragon, the demon, and the white dragon. Those are like the main things keeping him here right now. Let's just end. Let's see if he stays or not. Hopefully he will. Oh, nice. Good. Okay, so I think if I would have killed a ghoul or something like that, put more damage, it would have forced him to retreat. That's my guess on that. Okay, so we're going on savior mode here. I'll probably heal up the dragon, because I only got one healer there. And Vinard's strong against that red dragon, so gonna have to do that. Vinard's coming this way. Oh boy. Can we save the left team? That's the thing, though. Can we save the left team? Vinard's really strong. He's almost ridiculously strong in comparison to a lot of other characters. Vinard, I think, is definitely the strongest character in the game, bar none. I'm pretty sure he is. 135 defense. Agility. I mean, I think Drist is better evasion. Maybe possibly a little bit stronger attack. But I think overall Viner is probably one of the absolute strongest in the game. Part of it's because he's blue and there's so many red things in this game. You know? That, oh man, so I'm just playing defense right now. He doesn't have any healers. I'm gonna have to kind of either force him to run away. Alright, well let's heal him up right now, because he's gonna need it. If I take one of the red dragons here into the final fight, and plus it'd be stupid to try to lose a red dragon right now. You know. I don't know, Vinard or Drake? Well, Vinard's just gonna do frost spells right now. The dragon might do breath attacks, so let's do some breath attacks of our own here. Lower him down a bit. I don't want to do any super confrontational attacks. This won't do too much damage, but at least it'll get him a bit lower. And, you know, and this will clog them up on a bridge here. Vinard could stay and fight and try to kill this team, though. I could see that being a real thing. A little worried about that, but oh boy. You know what? Trying to save the scorpions, and this is a bit, I don't know. Viner's gonna nail him with a Geno Frost. I'm pretty sure that's the next plan of attack. So let's not get too greedy here. I might have to use the scorpion though. Oh, this is nice. Yeah, I might have to use the scorpion to some degree. He might even send the scorpion out here. Oh, I can get right here. I could get right there. Perfect. Well, I mean, I was definitely going for there anyway. Wait, is that? Do I have a? No, that's the wrong button. Why am I keep doing the wrong button? What's wrong with me? Okay, I got a rock. All right. Well, let's get some levels on Shast. Shast gave up his bare fist and went with an axe. I can move again. I can move forward. Oh man. Well, if they hit me with a divine ray and a magic spell, he could survive it, I guess. I do have more going. And Cai will go first. Yeah. Let us see. Cure it up though. Well, what would be more devastating? I think Divine Ray would be more devastating. Can I stone him? Nope. Okay, so he could definitely die. It's a little risky here. Hopefully I can stun her. Hopefully I can even hit her. Nope. Nothing like that. Alright. Level up a little bit, heal up. And I guess the fairy. The fairy can knock down the demon easily. She'll thunderbolt it to death. Into its grave. Send it to heaven, I guess. Or I can move Cai forward and blow them all away. It's not a bad plan, you know? But I'm looking to kill monsters here. I mean, I can move there. Alright, so what do we got? This thing's stoned, it's too high in hit points, I can't do much with that. Alucard could come and do the final attack, which would be cool. Alright, I got an idea here. Let's... Right, he can only really attack here anyway, so let's just have him do a free attack. I can't really get him to attack anything else, so this is all I can do with him. He could come attack the bishop. Let's see what my percentage is on my on the bishop are. 92, that's not bad. What to do with that? I think I'll move you there. Attack 96%, that's not bad. Oh, 167. Or I could have him attack around the water. Or I could do that. See, I'm just one space away from being able to hit him here. I wonder if a Geno-Thunder would get him low enough for a kill. I'm trying to imagine that. I could kill the demon or I could try to focus on him. I do need to level up the fairy, but the fairy can't do much else. Only Cai and the fairy can really work here. And Trigger can work outside the box. Let's see what my shot on him is. Nice. Very nice. I wonder if... Why don't we try this? Let me try this. Let's see how this works. Wait. Oh, the Pegasus goes, too. Oh, jeez. Well, if I didn't think about that. Well, this makes my job a little bit easier here. Completely forgot about you, Mr. Unibrow. Sorry. I'm very sorry I forgot about you. So we're going to make Cai go to work a little bit here. The fairy did get hit, which is nice. How far could I... Well, I don't want to go too far, but this should be okay. Alright. I need to really knock him down. This is the most powerful thing I have for a single attack. Let's see if I can get him all the way down to nothing. Good. That's good. I gotta get Alucard a kill. This should change the dynamic of the battle. 92, hopefully. Yes! He does it! He does it! He did it! Awesome. So we did it. We killed a leader, got Alucard a kill. 15. Maybe he'll be at 17. I don't know. I think Vinard will probably leave, though. I mean, if he really wants to stay, he can. It's going to be tough for this team. I mean, I might have to sacrifice the green dragon, I suppose, to save the red. I don't know how it's going to work, but... Biarte will be in a little bit of trouble, too. I mean... But the magic won't do too much to him, I suppose. Now, this is shocking. This is shocking, because he could have breath attacked down here. He could have definitely got me, but I guess they're like, ah, whatever, who cares, we'll just leave. That was probably the whole scenario. And this, that's not a bad tactic. Where is he going to go and attack? Oh, hey, that's not so bad. I don't care. I just want him to get some counterattacks, some points. What does he get for that? 69. Well, it's not great, but it's not bad. It's better than 60 or 50. So, okay. So we got victory. Hey, he's up to 16. I got Frost up to 10. I'm guessing I should turn Frost into a Marid. I suppose. You know, maybe that would coincide with the name a little bit. I do like Marids, but maybe I'll change the name on that, I suppose. Shutleis quest, some monster. Dragon slowly takes the poison fang. I don't need a poison fang. Jeez, I don't have any dogs on my team. I don't have a single dog on my team. This is ridiculous. Stop giving me poison fangs. See, this is the other thing. So, you know, I was being asked, oh, you should get the items that, you know, class up the angel immediately and just work on that. Do you know how long it's going to take to get that? Like, I can't guarantee that quest will ever even happen. I would like to, but I can't guarantee I'll ever get that quest. Look at this. No, not that. I have three poison fangs. Three poison fangs. I can't do anything with this. I don't have a single hell dog on my team. And that's what they're giving me. So, you know, as far as items are concerned, I can only work with what I have. I have this one for the Arc Seraph, so I'm going to go with that. So, that's the thing. I was pushing forward so fast, I didn't even bother. I didn't even bother to buy an Angel. Oh, man. All right, so... Okay, well, can I get an Angel up there instead? I know I can get Hydras. I know I can get Hydras. Well, here's the dog. So I get a dog with him. But I... Should I just get dogs just to equip it? That's interesting. Oh man, I need an Angel though. Let's move Shutleis here. Equip the Angel. I don't know if I get Angel from here. No. I think Caerleon has Angels too. Let's see if I'm right. No, rocks. Is Taos the only place you get Angels from? It might be. Wow. Taos is the only place you get Angels from in a Queen's Territory? Are you kidding me? Knight must be... When did this happen? I don't remember this ever happening. I remember you'd be able to summon a thing if you didn't have a knight there. Or wait. No. Maybe I don't remember correctly on it. I don't know. But... Okay, so we're sending Shutleis there anyways. He'll be able to get an Angel when I get the time. Let's look at the domain. We will attack here really fast if Driss does not attack, which he's been completely stupid about not attacking there. And then we will also attack into Norgard's territory, probably here. So then the next turn of events, we will pull an army back up to here while we're here, and it will attack down to there or something. No. We'll attack here first, and then I'll pull my defensive army back to here, and then I'll take my main team and just circle around this way. So yeah, we'll do that. Okay, so we're trying to get through this really fast. As fast as possible. See how far we can go. He classed up into that. I don't think I have any points for it, though. 45. And that's 30. That's 15. Nope, I do not. I cannot at the moment. Let's see. We got 1 star. Is that? Okay, so Shast is starting to grow up a little bit. Alright, so let's move on. What did I do here? Nobody really changed anything. We went to Taos, major anniversary. Okay, so we are going to Jukes. And, yep. I don't think I'm going to be attacked right now. No, not that. That would be nice to attack, but it's not going to happen. And plus, this is going to really change the dynamic of the Empire, because they're going to have to put their best up here to match Kai's team. That's what they will do. I'm just doing this just to break down the Empire a little bit. Some experience for this team also. Zemeckis is here, so this will be interesting. This will be tough. Yeah, this will be a bit tough. Alright. Save it up here. So, yeah, I mean, as far as voting for the other knights, I kind of already did a video and I was just kind of excited to get out of here and do another one because, as soon as I start to get to push the enemy, I like to just keep pushing at them, you know, get my win. And, everybody is tagged? Okay, good. Alright, so I got to attack here first. But yeah, definitely still vote for the Knights. If it's already been tallied up by now from the last episode, then I will let everybody know, but I'm not going to go into all that too much at the moment. We already saw the scene. Let's show them how to win. Fools, you cannot stop my conquest. So, I will fast forward to the battle here, and we'll see you in a second. I don't know if they're going to stay. They don't have a lot. They do have some devastating things, though. I think like a demon, a couple angels, Zemeckis, Esmerie. It's going to be a little bit of a battle. I don't have the best of the best stuff here, though. So they have a bunch of ranged things that could do serious, serious damage. I have to be on my toes a little bit. On my toes. A little bit. Okay, that was stupid, but I have to be a little bit cautious here because this is going to be a little tough. So, yeah, if you already voted for who you want for the final fight, it's all picked out. I'm sorry, I'm just, you know, this video is just going to keep playing like it is. I guess I don't have to apologize too much, really. But our Save Me Scorpion is here. Save Me number one. He's alive and well. Let's see if he can do some damage. Let's put him in the front line just a little bit. If he gets too carried away. Oh, he's got good enough evasion. He could dodge a Wyvern attack. That's nice. All right, so let's put you down there a little bit. She can't really go out to do too many things, but I could start wailing away on this demon here. Hopefully, it'll do something. I know I could have done like a Venom spell, maybe, but I want to kind of get in line for something more. And she's number three. Let's go there. I'm going to see if I can force a heal because only Esmerie can heal right now. Work on that. I might get a curse spell to the face, but shouldn't be so bad. And I got a little secret tactic here. If you're not paying attention, you won't see it. But if you are, you'll see what I'm about to do. So, alright. So, this is kind of the plan. If they stay, which I'm kind of thinking they won't. Yeah, why not? Let's do it. Wow. Dang. This thing's powerful even in a forest. It has worse hit percentage ratios. What is he at? Level 27? Let's see. He would be better off up here. Attacking this thing. I think I'll one-shot it. Oh! One hit point off. Oh, man. I was really thinking that he would. Critical. Good. Stop you. Let's move you forward. It's 100% already. Want to level this thing up, too. Why not? You know, get it some experience. Anybody need a heal? I think the Empire's gonna leave, though. I don't see why they would stay. This would be ridiculous if they did. Let's heal up. Let's heal him up a little bit. He's closer to all the front lines than anybody else right now. I mean, he's got great defense, sure, but should you heal? Let's see. Do I need a healer up there? Let's just move you down. Well, you know what? I should probably do Hallow, actually. Let's do Hallow. Who's going next? So Dinadan goes. Let's see who's going to go. Are they all going to go before me? I think they will. 17, 11. Yeah, they will all go before me. I guess it won't matter if I tried Haloing because they could all be gone if they did leave. Just wait, hope that they stay. Oh, yes! Yes! And it's a good thing I healed them up, too. I mean, they could have left, but just the fact alone that this happened. I mean, you could see he would have been down to, what, 300? 250, something like that. Yeah, he's going to get a lot lower now. Yeah, he would have been around the 200s. But Zemeckis is going to stay. I don't know if Esmerie will stay. She's going to be regretting that pretty soon here. If she does. Okay. Yeah. Lamoric would have been a whole lot lower. That would have been probably the death of him if the dragon wasn't stunned. Yeah, that would have been, he'd be in around the hundreds or something like that. You think you have what it takes, huh? You really do. Well, let's find out. Because I don't think you have what it takes. I think you're gonna burn out in a second here. Shield. I love the fact that they have shields here. I just think that's awesome. What to do with him, though? Yeah, here's a safe bet. Okay, do you think Merriot could get that kill? Because that's what I was kind of thinking. Kind of thinking it could happen, but, oh, two. Yeah, I still have... Oh, hopefully. Maybe. 112? Yeah, good. Good deal. Good deal, Merriot. Alright. She can't do much of that. Let's move forward into... Well, that thing's still stunned. Oh, she is a little bit lower. Let's go right there. In case things don't work out perfectly, let's try that. Number two. She just went with that, so that won't go immediately. That's a free hit. Might get the kill off the dragon, hopefully. See what goes next. Alright. Should I outright kill her? I suppose I can. But I'd like to kill some of these monsters off, because it's going to be wrecking my army somewhat. I don't really need that good of accuracy on her right now. I'm probably going to regret that. I just don't want to put him in too much danger at the moment. But, yeah, this should suffice for that. See, my plan was... Dragon Roar. I can beat down her MP. But I think they're going to leave anyways. I don't know. I think it's a bit ridiculous. I think they're just gonna leave. Let's just do that. Just move this forward. 192! Wow! I wasn't expecting that. I was thinking 170 or something, but he is level 17. So I guess I can't get her much more. Ward. He's gonna need it if he's gonna survive. I mean, I can heal him up, but he could get double divine raid. He really can. It's gonna really hurt if he does. Let's heal you up, little buddy. He's still kind of low. Yeah, he's still kind of low. I need to... freaking get him somewhere somewhat safe. Either that or just heal him up all the way. You know, let's just do that. Can I paralyze you? Can you let me get paralyzed here? Please? Never mind. Okay, so he's a bit lower. The forest isn't a great spot for him, honestly. It's just just not. What to do with him, though? Just set him right here, maybe? I don't know. A little worried with Scuba Steve. He's great, but... you know, something bad could happen. 56. 72. Yeah. 143. Wow. Yikes. Alright, should I bolt somebody, kill one of them, or should I just heal up? You know what? I should just heal up. Ooh, though. I guess Beowulf is a little lower. I was gonna heal up Lamoric, but I was hoping to get a stun with the giant. Or the Titan. Yeah, I can see why they decided to stay somewhat. Let's move you back here. Yeah, he's gonna be able to walk in here either way. No, he's gotta stay. He's gotta stay right there. Zemeckis can't walk in there from there. Only the Wyvern can walk inside that space and do an attack on Merriot. He could shoot me, though. I could get double shot. But that's about it. Hopefully that doesn't fully work. So this won't hurt me too much. 142? Really? Are you serious? Well, that's a good... that's decent tactical thing to do there. That works out for you. This won't work out for you, though. So that was it, pretty much. Zemeckis had to run. He thought he had something going for him, but... I mean, if he played it slightly differently, he could have had something, but he didn't focus on the right monsters. That was his point. But even then, you know, him trying to beat me is going to be insanely hard. So, all right, level 8, level 12, level 5. Nothing classed up right now. Nothing serious at work. New Almeki is invading. Oh my gosh, New Almeki is just gonna. Oh, he lost. He lost? Oh, he only sent one knight in there? Are you kidding me? I wish I could have seen that battle. That would have been amazing to watch. That would have been amazing. Okay, so they probably will stay for this. They probably will stay for this. My lord is building a new age. I will not let you interfere. It may be true, but I will interfere. I will interfere very heavily. So, we'll see you at the beginning of the battle. Alright. Okay, so let's start this battle up. This is going to be a little bit strange because I wasn't able to get everybody in the perfect position immediately. But I think if they are able to hit me, it's only going to be able to be on Cai from one side. So, it shouldn't be so bad. I can still reposition as I'm going through. But this is definitely a battle where you're really, really close to the enemy. This is very close to the enemy. So... alright, so, yeah, that should be okay. It'll be okay. I'll get everything repositioned and working out better. But, it's not too bad. I do need to level, you know, some of these knight, you know, some of these monsters up and stuff like that, too, so. It's not terrible. It's not terrible. It's still okay. But we do need to block Cai. Definitely. Do have to block him. Somehow I accidentally pressed the button to stop the dragon in the back when I was coming up here, so he didn't get to really get up here too far, but I will get him there. He will get there. Let's do breath attack there. And I couldn't class him up yet. Yeah, could not class him up yet. Everything's okie dokie! Alright, so Shast, you're gonna come in here, you're gonna do some damage. Hopefully, you will survive this fight. Got 100% on that. It's gonna hurt either way, because, you know. Oh, nice. Cool. We got Shast in the front lines. That's nice. Block you off here. Maybe stone you too. Let's throw that in there. Oh, no stone. I wanted to throw a stone in there for good measure. So we'd have something for us, you know? Alright, so we need to go. Yeah, about there is okay. Alright, so I'm pushing a bit aggressive here. I need to get Shast some experience, need to level him up a little bit. It'd be nice if I could at least round him out, get him to 15. That'd be really perfect, actually. Probably gonna have to heal up the rock. Probably more so. Yeah, the rock's gonna be damaged a lot. Good. Could he die? Oh, jeez. Yeah, with the white dragon. Oh, but I'm almost suspecting the white dragon's probably gonna, you know, breath attack down that way. The thing that's gonna be a little painful is those dogs. That bit in the way is gonna change dynamics of things pretty good. So, all right. Hang on a second. Yeah? Hey, good. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Did you get the message? Okay. Yeah, we can shoot for, like, 4:30. You know, earlier time. Mm-hmm. Yeah. So. Okay, so tomorrow 4:30 would be great. Get things rolling. Alright. Yeah. So we get it, the earlier the better. Mm-hmm. Okay, alright, take it easy. Yep. Bye. Okay, so what do we got here? I think a thunder spell outright kill it. Yeah. What to do? Okay, I got options. I got lots of options actually. Alright, so I got an idea. Let's start off with I'd love to do Geno Flame, but there's always so many red creatures to hit. There's two red creatures here. These other ones, they don't matter. Geno Flame. I'd love to do Geno Flame, but there's just so many red creatures all the time. There's barely any, there's barely any just plain, flat-out green creatures to hit with the Geno Flame. So I gotta go with the Frost. But I do like Frost. It's just that I use it so much, I'm just, like, you know, I want to do something different. So we can Halo him, but I wonder if I need to heal anybody. Do I need to really heal anybody? I do have the other unicorn. Well, he can't heal from there anyways. No, he can't. Oh, you know what? Yeah, I can do this. Do this, watch me do this. It's gonna be awesome. Because he's trapped. So he just put himself in there. A little bit of what I do too is to try to feign withdrawal or trap the enemy, which ends up working anyway. So, part of my strategies are a bit devious. So you think you got the advantage, but you don't. So. We are going to destroy this thing, hopefully. I don't know if it's gonna fully work. I react him. Heal twice. There won't be enough damage. Well, oh man, I don't know. Yeah, it is double black. Because I want to level him up too. That is 100%, because he is surrounded. But can he survive the following attacks afterwards? So what could really get him beyond that? So Kai goes, And then Gwynglin goes one. What's his range? Oh, we can't really go there. What's one? And after that, then we have Viarte. That goes. It's 14. And she goes. I think she goes. Or no, she goes. 12 Archer. And Archer attack would take him down if he's too low. Value card's too low, he will die. I gotta worry about that. I gotta hope that this Thunder Spell will finish it. But we gotta look at their intelligence first, see what. I think this will definitely be higher. 36-50. Well, he can't even attack him anyways there. Let's put as much into this guy as we can. I don't know if I can totally finish him, but maybe somebody else can. We'll try. Try it like that. If I get a critical with Alucard, then yeah. But we'll find out. 114. Just not enough. It's gonna hurt. It's going to hurt. Okay. They're probably not going to stay. I don't see it happening. I don't need them to stay either, really. There's not much more for me to do. Dragon would be good to kill. The Silver Dragon would be great to kill. See here, what's he gonna do? Oh, that is on his team. Oh, yikes. But I was kind of expecting something like this because he's hitting a leader and he's hitting a couple more of my guys. That's usually what they do. He could attack the other one again, too, but yeah. Alright, so what else to kill? Well, basically, this dragon right here is probably the best option. Could do something like this. Get more damage off of it. I think the Jin's okay. He only got hit once. I think he's got enough evasion. He'll probably survive the night. Let's do that. Let's level up Yarte a little bit here. Just to be safe. Because I don't really have to heal anybody up besides him, and nothing else is going to be able to hit him too hard, I don't think. And I can't really cure him from there anyways. So he's up to 15, that's nice. Save me Scorpion is actually literally here to save the day. Oh, he's at 100. Ooh. Yeah, he could die. I wasn't even watching that. Oh well. Oh well, I guess we lost a rock. He's only at 100. I don't think that's enough that I could really do much with. They put a lot of damage in that. Yeah, the centaur could do something. Let's see if he could kill him off. Oh boy, yeah, they could kill him. Yikes. Yikes. Oh, Frost is gone. We weren't thinking about Frost. Frost is totally gone. He's gotta be gone. Unless I save him with this. Unless I save him. I could do a Crybird attack and paralyze everybody, but then I will lose him. Let's just do this. Be on the safe side. Should heal up. I can't heal him. Can you go block? That's the other tactic. Can you block? Can you block? Can you even hit? No, you cannot, dumb giant. He's only at 300 hit points. I'm a little worried. I'm a little worried about that. Oh, man. Anybody ripe for the death? Nope. You know what? I'm going to risk Shast a little bit to try to save this gem if that's possible. I just don't see it being possible right now because I can't. Yeah, I could have went out blocked him, I suppose, but I want to get Shast some experience. The Jin might have to go. Not worried about the djinn. Not trying to save djinns. It's not my goal. Yeah, he's gone. He's gone. Goodbye, djinn. Goodbye, Frost. It's good. It was good having you on my team, but somebody had to go. And trying to level up a lot of people at the same time. I was hoping to do a physical attack, but they won't do that for him. Shast is going to take a while to level up. That's a guarantee. That is a guarantee. So, alright, so we lost the djinn. That was not the greatest thing to lose the djinn, but couldn't even class him up anyways. I have other stuff to worry about. That's not particularly... That wasn't even voted for the fight for Bulnoil either, so I'm not really too worried about that. Just going to worry about the main monsters I have for Cai and Dinadan right now. Oh, good, he got some intelligence. I need him to get some intelligence, so that's good. Langueborg quests, he trips on a stone, he dies. Oh, too bad. Langueborg has returned. This could be a cutscene here. This could be a cutscene. I don't know. It's painted. Cai's so helpless. Okay, so that wasn't the cutscene, but we are getting close to it. I'm very positive that that's the case. So, if everybody was hoping I wouldn't lose a djinn, sorry. But there were two monsters that were close to death. It was the phoenix or the djinn. Someone was going to die, that's for sure. Alright, so we're going to start to lose some territory here probably, but I'm going to move through Vinard's territory. I held this off, I held this whole location for some time. I pushed out as far as I can so they could eat up this castle and the next castle, and then by the time they're on the third castle, I might actually be a bit closer to killing off Vinard. And at that point, I will, I might black off Damas. I'm not sure, but if you want to, you know, leave some comments as to where I should block, where should I try to plug Leonia by the time they start moving in there, let me know. But it could be Driss that moves through, who knows, you know. Driss, I don't mind Driss taking up this territory. At least he'd be somewhat full to survive some more of the battle, because I'd like to be able to kill him off. Leoness was kind of like, if it happens, it happens. But I'd like to be able to take out Driss myself. He has some good knights to take. I want to take out Norgard, the Empire, and Driss. So that's probably my next plan of attack. That's kind of how I want to do it. Let's see here. Who classed up? I forgot. Anybody? Nope. This battle went pretty flawlessly. That I'm really happy that it went that flawlessly. Oh, yeah. What can we do with her? You know, the thing is, I don't know. I might leave the whole classing thing for people to kind of vote for. But, I mean, I need another pick for Merriot to center into the final fight anyways. But for right now, it'd be interesting to know what would be good for her. Because I know for Brangi and I turned her into a... for a Bulnoil fight, I turned into an Enchantress, and I also had her learn the healing classes too, I think. So I think I did both for Brangian, and then she was Artemis as well. So she was like, it was kind of funny, you know, fighting Bulnoil. I just pull off Genofrost and Brangian. you know, while she's an Artemis. That was kind of cool. But I don't know what you guys are thinking as far as that's concerned. Let me know. I mean, I've already done this before. I could beat this with her as just solely an Artemis. But if you want to see her cross-classed as something else also, let me know that. She's an expert. I could change her into a cleric, but I am... I might need a healer for this team. This might be... I don't know, just temporarily. Yeah, just temporarily I'll change her into that. Because if I switch teams up, or if Merriot goes away and I have a different kind of squad, I might need a healer. And if Dinadan's not with this team, then she'll be the healer. So that's how we'll do that. I got almost enough points. I got 30 points here for something. But they'll probably class up, so I'll just leave that alone. Let's see, what other items I get? Icicle Claw. Do I have a Griffin? I don't even know if I have a Griffin. I don't think I have a Griffin. Or maybe it's on my defensive team. Is that my defensive team? Let's find out. Okay, so... And let me know what you think about Shastu being a barbarian. That'd be interesting to hear what your comments are on that. Lost that gin. Let's see what we can get from here. Oh yeah, angel. How about that? We're gonna need an angel anyways. It's probably what I'm gonna need to do. I thought you could just... Maybe I forgot all about that. But I thought you could just summon the monster at a castle without a knight. But I guess not. Guess not. Okay, so I don't think I'll be able to equip it right away on the team. Because I'll be attacking right away. You know what? If that's the case, we'll just quest out Shutleis, so come back to the leader and I will have it. So let's do that. Alright. Okay, those two other guys came back. Let's quest them too. And let's move Dinadan up here. Did I already do that? Yep. I already did that. So, okay. So here's the map. We're going to end the video here. Yeah, as far as some of the other things are concerned, as far as, you know, what we should do with Shast, as far as classing up goes, I know people are suggesting I go through the Monk class, but I have no... It's not giving me the option for the Monk class. I have to have a Monk on my team, from what I remember, to be able to do that. Or I have to... And the same thing with Sahara, to change through the Ninja class. I'd have to have... Oh, what am I doing here? But, like, up here with Shast... I'd have to have those classes unlocked to be able to cross-class through it. So, all I can really do is go back to Grappa right now. I need to get that class. I suppose... I don't know. I suppose pushing Bilcock up to that class might do it. But... So I think you need a priest class to move up into the monk class. So that could do it. But he's way down on Hervory right now, and I can't really have him attack much. Because the team is mostly defensive. And I can't really come back here right now to do that. Because I can't move through enemy territory. So that's a bit of a dilemma right now, I suppose. Yeah, let me know what you think about that. I mean, to me it doesn't matter. Yeah, I could level up Bilcock into a monk class and then try to work on Shast as a monk class, I suppose. That will be some work. That will have to change some dynamics as far as where I'm attacking, though. So that will change some of the dynamics of the game to get to that position. But, So, yeah, that'll just change some of the dynamics of it. Oh, good, 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 good. Biarte. A fighter. So I turned him into a fighter. No, I'd only really be able to get to a can of beer, or I mean a Cavalier. And then, you know, then he'd have that, but it wouldn't be enough magic. It wouldn't really make much sense. I guess I'm just going to try changing him into Pyromancer right now, because that way he has magic spells that I can do with that. Chastis Barbarian might be interesting. So let me know what you think about Chastis Barbarian. Let me know what you think about putting Merriot through some other classes or whatever. Because I think, especially for like Lancer classes are probably barred from becoming Archer classes and vice versa. I think that's how it goes, but I think it also works the same way with Monk classes too. I think Monk classes and Grappler classes can't move through each other once they get to a certain tier. They're pretty much barred from moving through any more of that. But it could also be the same thing with Berserker, but I can't get to Berserker at the moment. Yeah, let me know what you think about all that stuff. But definitely, that's the end of the video here. I'm going to get the Angel up at some point in this playthrough. What you're going to see, though, let's talk about this for a second. So what you're going to see, this is my plan. I moved down there to attack just to gain extra territory so that they couldn't push into this territory too easily. That was the whole point of it. I didn't really need a knight here to do that because my main team is going to be pushing through here. So the next attack is going to come up to here. Zemeckis is going to be busy trying to reinforce this area here. I did destroy this, so this is very powerful. But Kai's team's a little bit stronger, so he'll probably put his best stuff here on Lydney to defend against Jukes, thinking I might come in that way, which I could. But I'm going to move up here to Cenadon, and then to Flogaroo, and then down to Cardiff. So that's my plan with that. I'm just going to ring around here, push forward a little bit more into this territory, and then do a dual attack at the end just to finish off Viner. Because Viner can't go anywhere. He's stuck now. He's totally stuck. So I got a secondary team coming here. We're going to finish off Viner. This will stop Omekia from moving north. And then I will start to push south through the Empire's territory and put some other defensive team somewhere here depending upon who takes it over and how much. And then we'll move south through here. We'll try to block off Lance as much as possible through this area here. And just work like that. Just level everything up. And then Lance will pretty much either be plugged here to the point that this will be available for him to come and attack. But at that point, when he gets down to here, I can stop this. I can plug this up. So I could hold almost all this territory and all this territory here. And Lance could probably maybe move. I don't know. We'll see how Lance can go. I think if I let the enemy get all the way through here, then Lance will be able to move through Norgard's territory and stuff like that. But I don't know. It's going to be chaotic, but it's going to be fun to watch. I mean, I usually have a different plan of attack that works right away, but this one will work for leveling. Especially if we're trying to level up all kinds of characters and do all kinds of crazy stuff, especially working with, you know, Brigandine fans that are watching this and, you know, kind of helping out these things. So that's the plan of attack. That's what we'll do. So next episode, I hope everything's voted for as far as the final knight coming with me to Bulnoil, but we'll see. If not, you know, we'll still try to work with other knights and try to level them up accordingly. And yeah, that's all I have for you. Sorry this was a very long episode. Hopefully in the future I'll be able to just pump out more videos of attacks and all that, but yeah, I can't really guarantee that, but we'll try. So, alright. Take care, and I'll talk to you later.